Criticizing Prince Harry and Meghan Markle has become a full-time occupation for some people. From calling them hypocrites for taking private jets while lecturing on climate change to questioning how they could have the audacity to shut their own car doors, the haters are usually out in force. Most of all, royal critics love to comment on whether Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are displaying the correct amount of respect toward the rest of the royal family. They accuse the couple of being rude to Prince William and feuding with Kate Middleton. They even said the Duke and Duchess of Sussex recently snubbed Queen Elizabeth by shunning her invitation to Balmoral. But is everyone just jumping to conclusions over Harry and Meghan's perceived rudeness? It's possible. Royal fans think Prince Harry and Meghan Markle skipped visiting Balmoral. Every summer, Queen Elizabeth takes a break from her dizzying schedule of royal engagements and heads to one of her favorite places in the world. Her Majesty makes an annual pilgrimage to Scotland, and rumor has it she is most relaxed and happy while she's there. The Queen even engages in unique pastimes, like washing the dishes after dinner. It's no secret that Queen Elizabeth loves her family. While on holiday at Balmoral, the Queen invites most prominent family members to spend time there with her, taking walks and enjoying nature. But this year, everyone is incredibly offended that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle allegedly turned down the Queen's invitation. The latest stunts from Meghan Markle have disappointed Queen Elizabeth, according to reports. The Duchess of Sussex made a few decisions in the recent weeks that hurt the Queen when she turned down an invitation to spend a few days of summer at the Queen's home in Balmoral but then flew to the US to show support for a friend. Early this September, The Sun reported that Duchess Meghan and Prince Harry decided they will not visit the Queen in her Scotland estate because of their son, Archie Harrison. Insiders said that the Sussex royals felt that Archie was too young to be traveling despite bringing their little boy to Nice and Ibiza in August. Queen Elizabeth was said to be looking forward to Duchess Meghan and Prince Harry's visit because the rest of her grandchildren and great-grandchildren were also in Balmoral. The Queen had been so set on enjoying a few days of merry chaos, but Duchess Meghan ruined her excitement when she and Prince Harry turned down the invitation. It would have been Duchess Meghan's first visit to Balmoral since she wasn't also able to go the previous summer while pregnant with Archie. It would have also been a chance for Archie to bond with his older cousins Prince George, Princess Charlotte, and Prince Louis, who have gone to Balmoral ahead with their parents, Prince William and Duchess Kate Middleton. What made matters worse was when Duchess Meghan decided to make a surprise visit to New York to watch and support one of her closest friends, Serena Williams, at the US Open. According to People, she flew without Prince Harry and left her son to the care of nannies at home in Frogmore Cottage. Critics questioned how Duchess Meghan could fly across the pond to support a friend but couldn't grant the Queen some courtesy by heeding to the invitation. A royal watcher from the Daily Mail said that this decision was undiplomatic and insensitive, that she has, no doubt, slighted the Queen. Serena is no relation. The Queen, by contrast, is baby Archie's great-grandmother, not to mention being in her 94th year, Sarah Vine wrote. It is not an unreasonable expectation that she might want to spend a little time with the new arrival. But no. The Duchess would far rather go to the US Open than travel to Scotland to be with her in-laws. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex had other travel plans. Even though Meghan Markle was technically still on maternity leave until this week, the royal couple has kept busy with Prince Harry making official appearances at multiple events. They also took a family trip to Ibiza with baby Archie in tow earlier in the summer. The fact that they went to Spain with the baby proves that they can't use new parenthood as an excuse not to go to Balmoral. But is it true that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle snubbed Queen Elizabeth by refusing to visit her at her favorite place? There's still time for Harry and Meghan to visit Queen Elizabeth. Though it's largely known as the Queen's summer retreat, the fact is that Her Majesty usually stays at Balmoral until early October. That means Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, plus baby Archie, still have a couple of weeks to squeeze in a quick visit. No one knows for sure if they intend to do that. Now that their fall schedule is picking up and Meghan Markle is officially back to work, there might not be time for a last-minute jaunt to Balmoral. But it's possible. Prince William and Kate Middleton were spotted at Balmoral just before their children Prince George and Princess Charlotte started up school again. But since the Duke and Duchess of Sussex don't need to worry about school schedules yet, it's entirely reasonable to think they'd head there on a quick midweek trip sometime soon. We'll see what happens.